This is a WWN Publishing Group recording. Copyright 2016. All rights reserved. One Kiss, a short story by Martha Sweeney from the Because Beards anthology. Read to you by the author. Chapter 4, Reese. I can't believe I fucking saw her. I was starting to wonder if I'd ever see my Cinderella again. I was instantly jealous of her teeth, having her sexy lips captured between them. Blood drained quickly to my groin, giving me an instant boner and temporarily slowing me down as I tried to get back onto the train. My legs couldn't move fast enough to get to her, and when the doors closed, I was devastated. Every day since our second encounter, which was 3 weeks ago, I've gone to that station at the exact same time, unless the trains are running late, hoping to see her. I don't know if she was leaving for work or just getting home from it. It doesn't really matter. I just need to find her. She consumes my thoughts and dreams. I'm a guy, so yeah, my carnal urges crave her. I want nothing else but to be buried inside her. I masturbate before going to bed, dreaming that it's her, and wake up with a raging hard-on that needs my fantasy to become reality. Once I satisfy my physical needs, my mind races, wondering what's her name, favorite color, favorite thing to eat, was the book she was reading for school or pleasure, and so much more. Dr. Langford? Hmm? I reply as my eyes flit across the iPad while I struggle to finish making notes. Dr. Langford, she repeats. Yes, sorry, Mrs. Hildreth, I reply. Puppy love, she states. What? I ask. It's in your eyes, Mrs. Hildreth informs. What's her name? I don't know, I answer truthfully. What do you mean you don't know? It's complicated, I sigh. Love is complicated, she declares. We only met twice, I inform. I hardly call it love. You're young, so I know you don't recognize it as such, she presents. But it's definitely love, regardless of whether you know her name or not. Soulmates from past lives who are working to find each other again. Sure, I comment, brushing it off. So, tell me about her as you examine Charlie, she encourages. There's nothing really to tell, I lie, shifting on my feet. Come on, Mrs. Hildreth coaxes. Besides, it's not professional for me to divulge personal information with patients, I remind. I'm not a patient, Mrs. Hildreth counters. You know what I mean, I state with a smile. Charlie doesn't mind. Do you, Charlie? She asks. Charlie meows and then brushes his head up against my arm. Hello, Charlie, I greet, petting him. How are you today? He's good, Mrs. Hildreth informs. I think he got one of the neighbor's cats pregnant. Pregnant? I repeat. He's fixed. That's what I thought, Mrs. Hildreth laughs. Looks like surgery didn't take. Did Mr. Manning do the procedure, I inspect? No, she confirms. When I adopted him, it said on his paperwork that he was fixed. Well, we'll need to check. And if he's not, would you like us to schedule it, I ask? Yes, Mrs. Hildreth replies. I don't need any more baby mamas getting mad at me and Charlie here. I snicker at the phrase baby mamas coming out of Mrs. Hildreth's mouth since she's in her 60s or perhaps 70s. You'll find her, Mrs. Hildreth announces. Who? Your lady friend, she clarifies. Love never fails. I smile and nod, hoping she's right. This is the end of this chapter. Thank you for listening. I hope you've enjoyed the story so far. To find out about new releases before the general public, be sure to subscribe to my newsletter. You'll find a link below in the description. Also, to be notified when the next chapter is published, make sure you subscribe to my channel.